Hi there. Today on Typical Books, it's going to be some new releases for September. Starting with local haunts. I'll get to the Horror Writers Association releases in a minute, but first off, pre-orders are ready for the BookTube HorrorTube Anthology Local Haunts. You can find out more at the link below to Regina's Haunted Library. She did a launch, an official launch. Paperback will be on pre-order soon enough, but October 1st everything will be available, and let me tell you, the book looks amazing. You'll see the cover by Cameron Rubik. There is a star-studded cast, if you will, of horror booktubers and writers that are featured in this anthology, and I am so flattered and pleased to be invited. Oh my gosh. So more on this later, but first, on to Horror Writers Association new releases upcoming for September. Okay, so there's quite a few and I've had to chop them up, so there might be another video coming next week. It's that we're so close to Halloween, I believe, that there are a lot of book releases coming out, and there aren't as many venues for authors to sell their work or to network with one another. So the internet and places like horror.org at the new releases members books page is the place to showcase your work. So I guess that's what's happening. So first off, we have Her Infernal Name and Other Nightmares by Robert P. Ottone. This comes from Spooky House Press and will be out at the end of the month. From waking fears to heartbreaking nightmares, this collection of short fiction is a glimpse into the terrors we face every day from the mind of Robert P. Ottone. So it is a single author collection. Lovely stuff. I love that title. And here's a nonfiction. I know that there's a lot of fiction fans here at Typical Books, and I myself am one, but I'm also a huge nonfiction fan, and here's one. Women Make Horror, Filmmaking, Feminism, and Genre. My friend Amy Jane Vosper will be very interested in this particular book. This comes from Alison, Peirse, and this comes from Rutgers University Press and is out soon. Women Make Horror is the first book-length study of women filmmakers in horror film and first all-women edited book on horror film, and the first book to call out the male bias in written histories of horror and then to illuminate precisely how and where these histories are lacking. Fascinating stuff, and really something that is, you know, a cumulative study, I'm sure, that has been on the minds of these authors for the past decade, if not longer. I know that it's been on my mind since I started watching horror films and didn't understand women weren't supposed to. The Night She Fell by Jennifer Soucy. This is an independent publication out soon. And Corey dreams of becoming a witch like her mama, but her spells continue to fail. When a man from their past returns to Greenwich, more than her ancestral magic sparks, unlocking a secret which inspires rage, betrayal, and the need to protect her remaining family. Wonderful sounding stuff. I like the title of this, and it speaks to some bizarro and, old-fashioned carnival thinking here. Ape in the Ring and Other Tales of the Macabre and Uncanny from Douglas Ford, and this comes from Madness Heart Press, and it is out. From the author of The Reattachment comes a frightening and twisted collection of stories that demonstrates Douglas Ford's imagination at its best. Ryan Dietrich calls this collection a David Lynchian labyrinth of chutes and ladders, a freak show of familial terror. Well, I was right on the mark, I think. The Ape in the Ring. Yeah, I'm very interested in this. The cover is somewhat lacking, the typography is interesting, but this is the sort of thing that I think might be an unsung gem. But Worse Will Come by C.C. Adams. I had read his novella Semen, and I really need to review that in my novella collection series anthology talk thing from Dream's Edge Publishing. Theo barely survived the horror of his childhood. The same horror will crawl out of the grave for him. Very short, to the point. Fantastic. Looking forward to that. Sins of the Father by J.G. Faherty. This comes from Flame Tree Press and is out already. Something evil lurks below the streets of Innsmouth, and only one man knows the terrible truth. Now he has to put an end to his father's terrible legacy before he loses everything in his life, including his own sanity. I hope that there's a description of the Innsmouth look in this book, because that's one of my favorite things, and it's nightmarish. I often have nightmares, and I wake thinking, there's no other way I could describe the look of that person but that Innsmouth look. Yee. I was kind of hoping to angle some of that into my upcoming Night Facebook of the Westmeath look, where there's people that live around the place that Black River is. But I don't really talk about the town folk too much, so maybe that means there's going to have to be a third book about the Westmeath look. Stalking the Moon by Angel Leigh McCoy. This comes from Wily Writers. And Vivian is schizophrenic. She can usually handle her hallucinations, but when one of them starts killing people, Vivian discovers that nothing in her world is as mundane as she thought it was. It's a long fall for the moon, and reality will never be the same. Very fantastic sounding. And this book is definitely out already. Ghastly Tales of Gaiety and Greed, Unauthorized and Haunted Cedar Point. This comes from E.F. Schraeder from Omnium Gatherum. Set on the Lake Erie coaster belt, Ghastly Tales and Gaiety and Greed takes readers on a haunted historical tour of a 150-year-old amusement park. Now, told in vignettes that weave stories, newspaper clippings, postcards, and images, this follows four families through the Deathcades Lakeside Resort and amusement park where everyone eventually returns. I am very interested to read that. So that is all that we have right now, and I will return briefly to thank Regina specifically for bringing Local Haunts to life, the BookTube anthology. Looking forward to the paperback book, to hold it in my hands. I read the stories, and the roster of us that appear in those pages is just fantastic. Once the paperback pre-order is live, I'm going to do another video talking about some of the background into my story specifically. So hopefully that'll just be a little teaser before October 1st. And then on October 1st, I do want to review it somewhat. If anyone has any ideas on how we can best spread the word and get this Local Haunts anthology into the hands of other readers, I'd love to hear it. And definitely take a look at the other BookTubers. I'm going to list them all below. I'm going to list them in subsequent videos that I talk about Local Haunts too. And I'm just so excited that this is hitting the shelves. So thank you very much for watching. If you're interested in any of these books or have read them already, let me know in the comments below. And make sure that you have an ooky, spooky day.